Hi guys, in today's video I'm gonna tell you why concrete is like gold, especially from some people working in construction. I will tell you all you need to know in terms of basic information about the concrete from construction site perspective, when you're gonna be working on site and especially when you're gonna be dealing with the concrete ordering and all the stuff. So guys, often on site, as a site engineer, you're gonna be actually cubing up the concrete, and this is in most cases the senior engineer gonna be ordering the concrete, dealing with all the timing, logistics and all the stuff, but at the end of the day, anything wrong gonna be put on you as well. So I'll tell you now about a few most important things when dealing with the concrete, guys. First thing is, as you saw in the title, the concrete is like gold, guys. So what does it mean? It means just purely that the concrete is money, and for some people it's really like gold. Even if you think it cannot be that much, guys, the amount of concrete wasted every single day just comes to huge amounts of money, really. So that's the reason why you have to look at it. On your side, you don't really want to be left with a few meters of extra concrete, especially if this is the late evening, and this happens even to the best engineers, guys. As cubing of concrete itself might seem like very easy task, guys, the construction site circumstances make it a little bit hard. And you can see actually on my videos here, when I give you the tips about the cubing up the concrete, even to help yourself with the EDM when you can, if you got irregular shapes, a little bit more about the concrete. But today I want to focus only, guys, on the construction site and what we need to know why we're dealing with the concrete here. So when we talk about money, guys, it's not only about the concrete itself, it's also the dealing with the batching plants and all the stuff. So I'm going to show you the few companies dealing with the concrete, so you can have a look yourself later. I'm going to start from Tarmac here. They provide the concrete. You probably saw some lorries of it coming, especially if you work in London, guys. But the Tarmac provides concrete all over UK, so I'm going to start with a few companies providing around the UK, and then I got two which operates in London, really. I'm going to leave a links to these companies. You can read a little bit about it here, and it's really worth to know a few things. So this is the Cimex, guys. It's a huge company. They're not only dealing with the concrete, obviously. You got product services. You can have a look here. Asphalt, street, cement, and all other stuff. But as we're talking about the concrete here, you just jump in the concrete section, and you can have a look yourself. We got a Hanson, the big company as well. It's one of the biggest one. So ready mix concrete. You can see here, guys, they say actually they are the UK's largest supplier of ready mix concrete. And I got two in London area. So it's London Concrete. Obviously, guys, if you work in London, you got a nice map here where they got the batching plants. So wherever your site is, obviously you're gonna be supplied by the closest batch to your site in most cases. And then the Procon ready mix too. I was using this before as well. So that'll be the company, guys. I really recommend you to go through these sites and have a look what they got to say here about the aggregate and all the stuff. But I'm going to come back now and tell you a little bit about what we need actually on site. So as I said, the first important thing is the price of concrete, guys. And you probably won't find it on the web pages, but the concrete going to be roughly between 100 and 140 pounds per cubic meter. This is obviously dependent on what type of concrete you're ordering and what actually agreement you got with the concrete supplier as your company. You have to also remember that if you order, in most cases, below 6 meters of concrete, you're going to pay extra money for the part load and you're going to be charged for it. So there is actually many ways you can waste money dealing with the concrete. And trust me, guys, I've seen full loads of concrete just being wasted completely, just put into the ground. And if you think about it, that the full load of concrete is nearly 1,000 pounds, now you know the concrete is like gold. So the second thing, guys, I would say that would be the timing. And I mean the ordering concrete and all the logistics around it. And you have to know, once your concrete is on site, after, in most cases, half an hour, 30 minutes, you're going to be charged for the waiting time by the supplier. So that would be another thing. You got only half an hour to place your concrete. But guys, when the time is ticking, it's not only the supplier and the money they're going to charge you, it might be not the huge amount. The bigger problem is concrete itself. It cannot really wait too long. So you guys have around 2 hours for it, and we actually counting the time from the water hits the cement. So it's not much time really, and that's why this job is all stressful. But what is the main property of concrete that we're going to be looking for to check if it's still alright and all the stuff is actually the slump. So the slump test is telling us about the consistency of concrete, so the concrete workability. And to be honest, before each pour, you actually should slump test each load, check if the concrete delivered is actually per your specification. It might be S2, S3, depending on what type of concrete you need. I'm going to leave the table in the description so you can have a look look what H2, H3 and S3 means in terms of ranges when the concrete cone collapses, and then based on this you're going to calculate your slump. So what I want to tell you as well, guys, you don't really want to end up with a few lorries actually waiting for you to be discharged, as you might be actually one to blame for it. And this is causing all other problems as well in terms of logistics, as there might be actually the block in the road even, and the guys waiting for you. So that's another one. That's all in timing, I would say. That all this dealing with people, with getting ready the elements to be poured. And as you know, everyone wants to do as soon as possible, but it's sometimes not ready, and you need to call the concrete while they're still finishing. And this is all the small things, guys, we need to think as the site engineers. What I would say is very important, guys, when you're dealing with concrete, especially under pressure, and you got few other mixes, you need to make sure the proper mix is gonna go to the proper element. What I mean by that, you might be actually dealing with a C60 concrete, which is gonna go only to the columns, and then you can have the same day pouring C40 concrete, which is gonna go to the slab. And then it's your job, actually, it's our job, our engineer's job, to keep an eye on this. The right concrete is placed to the right destiny, guys. And another thing would be just you need to make sure as well that you're going to collect the samples and the cubes going to be made. And this is actually our job as well, to make sure the cubes not going to be mixed later. Some C60 goes to C40 and C40 to C60, and the result is going to be completely wrong. And despite you're probably going to have some cubemen on site, this is our job just to keep an eye on them, actually. So that will be a little bit about the procedures. But the most important thing, guys, don't add water to the concrete, please. Don't leave the guys doing whatever they want. You need to keep an eye on them. This is very important stuff, as this is changing the water to cement ratio. So properties of concrete you order are going to be completely different when you're going to place the concrete. So it's really bad, guys. So to sum up, guys, I hope you understand now why the concrete is like gold. And trust me, for some people, it really is. So you need to remember, guys, if it's cubed wrong, if it's coming too early, or if the concrete comes too late, it's all down to you and you're the one. And when it's all perfect, the timing is perfect, the amounts are perfect, you're the hero. I'm just joking, guys, you're just doing your job. So I hope it helps you guys to understand what problems actually on site, and also what are the most important things you need to keep an eye while dealing with concrete on site in terms of concrete deliveries, procedures, and all the stuff to be a good engineer. Please let me know if I missed something, and leave the comments if you got any questions. Hit the like button too. And please, guys, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to join the best civil engineering community. Thank you again for watching, and see you next time.